Hi, this video is a brief overview of margin of error and confidence intervals. And if you'd like this worksheet, you can get it on my website at caraleemath.com. And I want to show you by way of an example what confidence intervals mean and what margin of error means. Okay, so here's an example. According to a Gallup.com poll in 2017, 29% of hourly workers and 41% of salaried workers are completely satisfied with the amount of money they earn. The survey had a margin of error of plus or minus 5%. Sometimes you don't even see the percent on there. Sometimes it'll say plus or minus 4, plus or minus 2, and those mean percent. This is an actual study I just looked up, so you're welcome to go to Gallup.com, follow this link, and check it out. They are taking all kinds of polls all the time, and it's really interesting to look at. Okay, so we want to write the confidence interval for this group. The confidence interval is related to margin of error. So mostly in the media, what you see are called point estimates. So this 29% and the 41%, it's called a point estimate. Think about it for a second. They took a sample of maybe 1,000 people. What if they took a sample of a different 1,000 people, and a different 1,000, and a different 1,000? You would get a slightly different answer just based on the statistical variation, just on the sampling variation. So variation from sample to sample. So what we do is we give this margin of error, and we'll talk more about how to calculate it later on. But they put a margin of error on it based on the sample size and also based on something called confidence level. Okay, so if they tell us plus or minus 5%, then that means this 29% could actually be 5 less or 5 more. And that's the confidence interval. So in statistics, we usually use a confidence interval to give that range versus a point estimate. Because with a point estimate, someone might think that that's the actual value, that's the actual value of the parameter. And really, we don't know that that's the actual value, but we can give it a range. So for hourly workers, that's the 29%. So if we take minus 5, so that would be 24%. And add 5, so that'd be 34%. So that's our confidence interval. So a statistician would say from 24 to 34% of hourly workers are completely satisfied with the amount of money they earn. That shows the variation in samples. Very similarly, for salaried workers, it's also plus or minus 5 because they use the same sample size for this survey. So minus 5, so 36% to 46%. So a confidence interval is found with using the point estimate and the margin of error. The minus part goes first because we always put the smaller value first, and then the plus part gives you the upper number. And we write them in parentheses with a comma in between. So that's the difference between margin of error and a confidence interval. Thanks for watching this video.